Hey there, folks. Timmy Williams here while everyone else is at lunch. You know, one of the hardest things about making a comedy show is staying relevant so that 5 or even 10 years from now, people that aren't my mom will still think the show is funny. That's why I've built this time machine here, old Bessie. By traveling into the future, I'll be able to see what people think is funny years from now. That way I can report it back to my brothers and the Whitest kids you know, and we can keep making this show forever. But enough yakking from me, right? Let's go to the future. Ow! God damn it! Ah! God! Ah, God damn it! Here we go! Wow! The future is really fun, you guys. Turns out they love swearing and farts just like us, so the show will be just fine. Plus, I totally banged some lady that looked just like my great-grandma, and then I talked her out of marrying some douchebag. Whoa! This must be some kind of cool future technology from all these neat clothes, huh? Well, goodbye, everybody. Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye. Bye, everybody. Goodbye. Goodbye. Do-do-do, do-do-do.
Well, from the looks of the ultrasound, we can tell that the fetus is progressing nicely. His heart rate is perfect. Cynthia, you seem to be doing swimmingly.
Thank you.
Have you two given any thought as to whether you'd like a boy or a girl?
I'm sure whatever the good Lord gives us will be good enough for us.
Well, we are coming upon the period in your child's gestation when certain traits are starting to be locked in. And thanks to modern medicine, we can influence those traits with hormone therapy.
Really?
Absolutely.
Wow.
So what would you prefer, boy or girl?
Well, I mean, I guess a little girl could be nice.
Yeah, but boys are funnier.
That's true. Let's go with a boy.
Yeah,
go funny. Now, let's talk about eye color.
You can decide eye color?
That's amazing.
Wow. Well, It might be fun to go a little exotic, you know, blue.
Well, I mean, we do have green eyes. Maybe we don't want to meddle with things that
Why
much.
Don't we flip a coin?
All right. Okay. Call it, honey.
Tails.
And heads it is. Green eyes.
Fun! White or black?
What?
Huh?
Would you like a white or a black baby?
That's a choice.
Or Asian, or Mexican, we have many options.
Oh, well, I mean, we're both white, so.
It might be a little weird if.
So that's how it's gonna be, huh?
No, it's not gonna be like anything.
So you want me to put down black?
Let's just keep it the way we had it.
Well, you haven't told me a race yet.
Why don't we just leave it like us?
Like you, huh?
Yeah.
Gay or straight?
That's not really an option, is it? I mean, I don't really care. I've never really thought about it, really. It could be either one. I guess if I had to pick off the top of my head, I go, I don't know, straight. But I am such a big fan of the gays, so...
They are funny.
You want to go funny again?
Well, how funny does our baby need to be, really?
He's already gonna be funny.
So do you guys want to flip a coin again?
We could. All right. I guess, heads, he will be a straight baby. And tails, he will be...
Funny.
Funny. Funny!
Yay!
Very good. Good for you. Now, would you like your child to have one leg or two?
What? Well, that didn't go well.
I cannot believe you doubled back on the whole black thing.
I choked.
We're gonna have a gay black pirate baby.
This baby better be hilarious.
New from Johnson & Hedges, the most exciting board game ever invented.
Ever?
Yes, ever. Crazy Chase is the only board game with literally 1,000 dice. Just dump the dice, count up your total, and make your move. And the first one to the castle wins! From the makers of Obey Your Nanny.
Wow. Mr. and Mrs. Howard sure do look happy ever since they got their boy Bill back from Vietnam.
Yeah, about that. Has anyone had a chance to talk to Bill since he got back?
Nah, man, he's been mobbed.
Yeah, he's been Mr. Popular ever since he got back from the war.
Well, I did, and I gotta say, something about him seems a little bit different.
Or it's crazy. Changes people.
Hey, guys. Great American barbecue, huh? Rock and roll.
Yeah.
Hey, Bill. Good to see you, man.
Yeah, buddy. Good to have you here. So, how was it over there?
Beautiful country, fighting brave soldiers. But war is not for me. Good to be back in U.S. America!
Yeah, you really missed U.S. America, didn't you, Bill?
Oh, I miss my country so much. Mickey Mouse, Ferrari, Elvis Presley.
You see, I don't remember Bill being such a big Mickey Mouse fan. In fact, in high school, Bill's locker was covered with Daffy Duck posters and handwritten signs that said, Daffy Duck rocks, Mickey Mouse sucks.
Hey, Bill. Do you remember when I broke my leg in sixth grade?
Oh, yeah. I'm so sorry. I cry and cry all day.
Yeah. How'd I break it?
We'll get shot in head by valiant sniper hiding in tree. Very good idea. But now have amnesia, not remember every little thing.
Yeah, Bill not remember every little thing, like being left-handed.
What you trying to say?
Oh, I think you know what I'm trying to say.
You think I'm not real Bill?
Yeah, I think you're not real Bill.
You think I only know about Elvis Presley because I sneak up and watch USO show through binoculars in jungle?
Yeah, we're starting to.
You think I kill Bill, take his dog tag so I can come here, live fast life, beautiful women in American country?
Yeah, we sort of think that.
You think I come here, lay low, enroll in small liberal arts college so I can buy time till I can assassinate President Johnson when he least expects it?
Yeah, that's exactly what I think you're doing here.
You know, I may be too cowardly to go over there and fight you people, but I am not too cowardly to kick your unarmed ass at a barbecue down the street from my house!
Hey, what's all the commotion about over here?
Mr. and Mrs. H, unfortunately we have something to tell you about Bill here.
Isn't it great to have him back?
Our boy, the war hero. I don't know what I'd do without him.
So, you boys had something to tell us?
Yeah, you have something to tell them.
It's just really good to have him back.
You could say that again.
Well, back to the dogs.
See you, boys.
Okay, now you listen up. We're not gonna blow the whistle on you, but if you do go through with your plan and you assassinate President Johnson, that's gonna break Mr. and Mrs. H's hearts, and we can't have that. So if you're gonna stay and be Bill, you've gotta be good.
I understand your concern, and I accept. I know Kill Lyndon Johnson. You are good friends.
You're a good friend too, Bill.
Hello? Ho Chi Minh? This fake Bill. I know Kill Lyndon Johnson.
See? He's calling his boss.
Yes, no. My parents are good people.
Yeah.
My friends are awesome.
Yeah.
I love my friends.
We love you, Bill.
I love America.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
I'm so glad I killed real Bill.
Yeah.
No, dude, that's too much.
Leading off is my message, and bringing up the rear is Future Glue, followed by Shea Bisquet and Mother's Friend from Work. Up here comes May the Horse Be With You, followed by Gambling is a Disease, and he's followed by Grass on the Field, who's neck and neck with Deep Dish Pepperoni Pizza, and My Ex-Wife is a Horse. Following them is Hung Like a Horse, and rounding the bend now is Secretary. The horses are still going, and the horses are running around the circle, and they are running around the circle, and they are still running around the circle, and all the horses are doing very well, especially the brown horse, who is in the lead, and the brown horse is still, oh, we have a winner, and the winning horse was, blah, 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 blah. That's right, he won.
Previously on the Civil War on Drugs.
We're gonna throw a demonstration this weekend to try to keep the weed stuff legal.
If this protest goes well, we're gonna have to keep the momentum going.
These people really care about that weed stuff.
Union or Confederate?
What?
If on the way to DC we run into any more of these anti-protesters, we need to make sure that we can—
Anti-protesters?
Yeah, those guys you were fighting.
Local boys become Confederate heroes!
I want these boys dead.
Stay your dead.
Be God, I can't come!
Get back! Through the woods, Sam!
And now, the Civil War on Drugs.
It's them!
Why did they all just throw their guns on the ground?
We don't want no trouble. We've heard about you guys.
You have?
Sure. You're the Dixie Devils. You're all over the papers.
We are?
We just want you to know, none of us are gonna get any funny ideas.
We'll do whatever you want.
Legalize it?
Sure thing, man. Consider it done.
So, what happens now?
Well, you're in charge, boss. We're your hostages.
But, like, what do we do?
Well, I guess you could list your demands to General Ulysses S. Grant.
Oh. Well,
How do we find that dude?
Oh, he's drunk off his ass over in that big tent over there.
He's in there?
That's him.
Mr. Grant?
What? Well, tell him you got some demands.
We have some demands.
Who is it?
The Dixie Devils.
Come in.
Hey. Hi.
Well, well. If it isn't the heroes from the southern states. What can I do for you boys?
Well, we're in your base and we have all your dudes.
Is that right?
Sure did. We put up a hell of a fight, but they got us.
Well, I see your reputation is well earned. What do you boys want?
We need to go to... to go to Washington to talk to President Lincoln.
Really? Okay. So you want me, leader of the Union Army, to take you two boys, the most notorious warriors in the Confederate Army, to have a little sit down with the president of our country, right? Get old FaceTime. What are you boys gonna talk about?
How it's bullshit that weed stuff's illegal. Yeah, I mean, as long as nobody's being hurt, what gives you the right to go around and tell people how to live their lives?
Well, that's rich, coming from a Confederate.
You're the f***ing Confederate.
You're the f***ing Confederate!
Guys, look, we just think that everybody should be free to make decisions for themselves, okay?
That is what this war is about.
Yeah, we know.
Yeah, we started it.
I don't know why you two boys are out there fighting, but I'm out there for one thing. Freedom.
Oh. Well, good.
I fight so that a man can work as he wants to work and live as he wants to live.
And smoke what he wants to smoke.
Sure. I fight so that men can cast off the shackles of oppression and say loud and clear that no man is subservient to another.
Yeah!
Oh my God, that's totally the same stuff we're into.
Freedom is not just a luxury to be enjoyed by the elite and the powerful. It is a sacred right to be shared by all men.
Yeah, that's what we've been saying this whole time.
And it is a right that is promised to us by this great nation, the United States of America. Oh. You boys don't have any whiskey, do you? Oh. This is the worst part of my day. No.
Oh. Oh. Oh my God.
Oh. Oh. Mm-mm.
No. No.
I'm just messing with you guys. I got another bottle over here.
Sir, no. Mr. Grant, I think we made a mistake.
Yeah. I mean, we thought you guys were the anti-protesters, but you guys are all about letting people get blazed.
I mean, it was those other guys who started all the fighting in the first place. We just want everybody to be chill.
Well, why don't you boys start by putting down your guns?
Oh, right. Sorry about that. Yeah. Super not chill.
Yeah. Ah! Suck a dick!
Not cool.
Next on the Civil War on Drugs.
Gotta warn General Grant.
Oh, shit.
Let's line them up!
They're right on top of us.
Drugs! I love the shit that comes out of a man's mouth right before he gets a bullet in the brain.
He made y'all suck his dick?
Fire.
Holy shit!
Okay, just leave.